Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on differences between DFS and BFS in data structures or design and analysis of algorithms. So before going to the differences between DFS and BFS, first of all, we know about what is graph traversing. Graph traversing is nothing but visiting all the vertices in the given graph exactly once. So that is nothing but graph traversing. So there are two graph traversal techniques are there. First one is DFS, stands for depth first search technique. Second one, BFS, breadth first search technique. So now, in these techniques, how we are traversing or are visiting all the vertices in the given graph. Okay. So now we are going to what is the difference between DFS and BFS. Okay. The first difference is the idea of DFS is proceeding to higher levels successively in the first opportunity. Then later we backtrack and add the vertices that are not visited in the given graph. Okay. So whatever the idea I am telling, this idea can be explained with this example. Okay. So, this is the given graph. In this given graph, this is the first level, and this is the second level, and this is the third level, and this is the fourth level. So, there are four levels are there in the given graph. The first level contains vertex 1. The second level contains vertex 2 and vertex 3. The third level contains 4 vertices, vertex 4, vertex 5, vertex 6, vertex 7. And the fourth level contains a single vertex, that is vertex 8. Now, how we are visiting the vertices in the given graph using DFS technique? Okay. So, in the first level, that is only one vertex is there. First, we are visiting the vertex 1 in the first level. Okay. So, after visiting the vertex 1 in the first level, what are the adjacent vertices for vertex 1? So, for vertex 1, the adjacent vertices are vertex 2, vertex 3. Okay. Among the two vertices, we are taking the first opportunity. First opportunity is visiting the vertex 2 first in the second level. Okay. So now we are visiting this vertex. Okay. So this is the first opportunity. This is the second opportunity. Now we are going to the first opportunity. Then we are visiting the vertex 2 in the second level. Okay. So after visiting vertex 2 in the second level, what are the adjacent vertices are there for vertex 2? That is vertex 4 and vertex 5. So among the two vertices, what is the first opportunity? That is vertex 4. Now we are visiting the vertex 4 in the third level. Okay. So after visiting the vertex 4 in the third level, next we are going to the next higher level. So in the next higher level, what is the adjacent vertex for vertex 4? So vertex 4 adjacent vertex is only 8. Okay. So this is the first opportunity. There are no adjacent vertices are there for vertex 4 except vertex 8. So now we are visiting the vertex 8 in the fourth level. Okay. So after visiting the vertex 8 in the fourth level, there are no higher levels are there. So again, we have to backtrack. So backtrack to previous levels. Okay, what are the adjacent vertices for vertex 8 in the previous level? So that is vertex 5, vertex 6, vertex 7. So among them, we have to take the first opportunity. So that is vertex 5. So now we are visiting the vertex 5 in the third level. Okay, so next, after visiting the vertex 5 in the third level, what is the next adjacent vertex for vertex 5? Vertex 5, only vertex 2 is there, but vertex 2 is already visited. So again, we have to backtrack to vertex 8. Okay, so then what are the adjacent vertices for vertex 8? That is, vertex 5 already completed. Next, vertex 6, vertex 7. Okay, so among them, we are taking the first opportunity, that is vertex 6. Okay, so after visiting the vertex 6 in the third level, okay, then what are the adjacent vertices in the previous levels? That is, only vertex 3 is there in the second level. That is only the first opportunity. So now we are visiting the vertex 3 in the second level. Okay. So after visiting the vertex 3 in the third level, in the second level, okay, what are the adjacent vertices for vertex 3? So vertex 1 in the first level and vertex 7 in third level. So our vertex 1 is already visited previously. So then what is the first opportunity is there? Only vertex 7. Now we are visiting the vertex 7 in the third level. Okay, so the DFS order is, first we are visiting vertex 1, then we are visiting the vertex 2, then we are visiting the vertex 4, then we are visiting the vertex 8, then we are visiting the vertex 5, then we are visiting the vertex 6, then we are visiting the vertex 3, then we are visiting the vertex 7. So this is the DFS order. Okay, whatever I am telling the idea behind DFS, that idea can be applied on this given graph. So this is the DFS traversing order for the given graph. So 1, 2, 4, 8, 5, 6, 3, 7. This is the DFS order for the given graph. So now we are going to BFS. So the idea of BFS is, visit all the vertices on a given level, visiting all the vertices on a given level sequentially before going to the next level in the given graph. So that means we are visiting the all the vertices on a given level. After visiting all the vertices in a given level, so then we are going to the next higher level. Okay. Without visiting all the vertices in a graph on a given level, so then there is no possibility for visiting the vertices in the next higher level. Okay. So that means the idea of BFS is visiting all the vertices on a given level sequentially before going to the next higher level in the given graph. Okay, so that whatever the idea I am telling, that idea can be applied on the given graph. Okay, so this is the first level and this is the second level and this is the third level and this is the fourth level. Okay, so first, visiting the vertex 1 in the first level. Okay, so visiting the vertex 1 in the first level. After visiting the vertex 1 in the first level, okay, so then what are the adjacent vertices for vertex 1? That is vertex 2 and vertex 3. So now we are visiting these two vertices in the second level, that is vertex 2 and vertex 3. So then we go for next higher level, so that is 4, 5, 6, 7. So then we are going to the next higher level. The next higher level contains only a single vertex, that is vertex 8. Okay, visiting all the vertices on a given level sequentially before going to the next higher level in the given graph. So that is the idea of BFS. So first visiting the vertex 1 in the first level. After visiting the vertex 1 in the first level, then we are going to the next higher level. In the next higher level, there are two vertices are there, that is vertex 2 and vertex 3. After visiting all the vertices in the second level, then we are going to the third level. In the third level, there are four vertices are there, that is vertex 4, vertex 5, vertex 6, vertex 7. After visiting all the vertices in the third level, then we are going to the next higher level, that is fourth level. Fourth level contains only a single vertex, that is vertex 8. Okay, so this is the BFS order for the given graph. Okay, so this is the increasing order. This is the increasing order of visiting of all the vertices on a level by level in a given graph. Okay, next one. Second difference, BFS uses stack data structure to store all the nodes in the given graph. BFS uses stack data structure to store all the nodes in the given graph. But whereas BFS uses queue data structure to store all the nodes in the given graph. Next, the third difference is DFS is edge-based algorithm. DFS is edge-based algorithm. We are taking the edge in the first opportunity. Okay, this edge is preferred, this edge is preferred. Which edge is first? First priority is there. That edge we are taken. So DFS is an edge-based algorithm, whereas BFS is an vertex-based algorithm. Okay, in the first level, we are visiting the vertex 1. Then we are going to the next higher level, that is second level. After visiting two vertices, that is vertex 2 and vertex 3, then we go for next higher level. After visiting vertex 4, vertex 5, vertex 6, vertex 7, then we are going to the next higher level. In the fourth level, that is fourth level contains only a single vertex, then we are visiting that vertex. So the order is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So because of that reason, BFS is vertex-based algorithm. Here, DFS is an edge-based algorithm. So this is the fourth difference is, this is the given example graph. For this example graph, this is the DFS order. BFS order. And whereas in the BFS, on the same given graph, what is the BFS order? So that is the BFS order. Okay. The next difference is memory consumption is efficient in DFS, whereas in BFS, memory consumption is not effective in BFS. We already know that in the case of BFS, stack data structure is used. In the case of BFS, queue data structure is used. Already in queue data structure, we already know the disadvantage of queue. So whatever the elements that are deleted in the queue, so that space is not utilized. So that is the disadvantage of queue. Okay, so because of that reason, memory consumption is not effective in BFS, but whereas in the case of DFS memory consumption is effective. Next one, DFS is not an optimal algorithm, whereas in the case of BFS is an optimal algorithm for finding out the shortest distance not in cost. So because of that reason, we can say that BFS is an optimal algorithm, because we are finding out the shortest distance path, not in cost. So because of that reason, we can say that BFS is an optimal algorithm and DFS is not an optimal algorithm. Next one, DFS constructs narrow and long trees. Okay, so DFS is, while traversing the graph using DFS, we are proceeding to higher levels successively. After that, we are backtrack and add the vertices that are not visited. So because of that reason, DFS constructs narrow and long trees. So whereas in the case of BFS constructs wide and short trees, because here in the case of BFS, level by level ordering is there. So level by level ordering, we are visiting the vertices in the given graph level by level. Suppose we are in the first level, after visiting all the vertices in the first level, then we go for second level. After visiting all the vertices in the second level, then we go for third level. So because of that reason, BFS constructs wide and short trees, whereas in DFS constructs narrow and long trees. Okay, next difference is, vertices along the edges are explored in the beginning while traversing. Okay, vertices along the edges are explored in the beginning while traversing. So this is already shown in the fourth point example. Okay, in the case of BFS, oldest unvisited vertices are explored first while traversing. Okay, we are already seeing in the fourth point in the differences. Okay, next one, ninth point, DFS follows first a path from starting node to an ending node, then and so on. Okay, so here we are visiting the vertex in the first level. After visiting the vertex in the first level, then going to the next higher level. So what are the possibilities are there? Among the possibilities, we are taking the first opportunity. So according to the first opportunity, we are visiting the vertex in that level. So after that, we are going to the next higher level. What are the possibilities are there? Among all the possibilities, we are taking the first opportunity. So in this way, so DFS follows first a path from starting node to an ending node. So the same procedure can be followed until all the vertices are visited in the given graph. But in the case of BFS proceeds level by level ordering. Okay, so suppose we are in ith level. After visiting all the vertices in the ith level, then go for I plus 1 level. After visiting all the vertices in I plus 1 level, then go for I plus 2 level. After visiting all the vertices in I plus 2 level, then go for I plus 3 level. So the same procedure continued until all the vertices in all the levels are visited. Next one. What are the applications of DFS? The applications where we are using the DFS technique, that is strongly connected graphs, and second one is acyclic graphs, and third one is topological order. In the three applications, we are using the DFS. So what are the applications of BFS? So the applications of BFS, one is bypass shaped graph, and second one is connected components, And third one is shortest path present in a graph. So in these three applications, we are using the BFS technique of algorithms. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So Dimpela Srinivasa Rao. Dimpela Srinivasa Rao. Srinivasa Rao. Thank you.